Hey, friends, welcome back to another episode of Priorities on Purpose. I am your host, Christian life coach and faith mentor, Melissa Batt. So happy that you came back to listen to another episode. And I have to tell you, I hope you have already listened to part one of the podcast episode with Rachael Gilbert. Today, we are wrapping up that episode. This is part two. We're going to talk all about the struggles with finding a therapist, how to find a therapist, tips for working well with your therapist. And then we're going to talk about listening to your body and the struggles with not doing that, how it can be harmful, and also like how to start doing that and what that looks like. So again, this episode is going to be fire. If you haven't yet went and bought Rachael's book, Image Restored, Tear Down Shame and Insecurity to Experience a Body Image Renovation, you're going to want to go do that. The book, again, is full of so many things. Like, it's got like a body image journal in there. Like, she walks you through how to flip the script. I talk about that all the time, taking our thoughts captive, recognizing our thoughts and when they're not healthy, how to turn that around. She helps you pinpoint where it came from so you can recognize areas of brokenness and come back and let God heal you in that area. And so, again, the book, so good. As a licensed therapist, she has some tips, tricks, and tools that I just believe are incredibly beneficial, and it's all in her book. So check that out. And let's get into it and start where we left off in the last episode. Hey there, I'm Melissa Batt, the host of Priorities on Purpose, a podcast for overwhelmed women who are tired of going through the motions. You know there has to be more to this life than the cycle of numbing out, scrolling social media, exhausting yourself with a never-ending to-do list, and still feeling like a failure at the end of the day. You have hope that tomorrow will be different, and I'm here to help you make sure that it actually is. I'm a Christian life coach, and on this podcast, we talk all about intentional living, mental health struggles, and tangible ways to be the best versions of ourselves with Jesus at the center. I promise to be your hype girl and biggest cheerleader as I share simple strategies to help you get out of your rut, eliminate distractions, and live the life you are created for. Are you ready to go beyond existing and learn how to truly live? Put your earbuds in and let's get to it, friend. And at that point, that's when I was like, we're done here.
Yeah.
That's not like, I'm beyond that. Been there, done that. And the reason I'm wanting help is to not do that, you know? Yeah. And so do you have any suggestions on like where to go for someone to really like find a good therapist?
Yeah.
Because they're not all one size fits all.
No, for sure not. And I would say, first of all, define for you what does a good therapist look like, right? You know, because that's very different for everybody. And then here's the interesting thing about therapy. With coaching, you can do it across states. With therapy, we can only counsel in the state we're licensed in. There are some states that are starting to accept this, but anyhow, at least my state hasn't done it yet. Come on, Texas, get on board. So that does limit, you know, which I know you mentioned virtually, not everybody's a fan of virtual, but two websites I always recommend to people, aacc.net. That's an American Association of Christian Counselors. And so, you know, you're at least getting a Christian counselor if that matters to you. If it doesn't, then you may not want to go to this site, but then you can put in where you live and it'll pull up, you know, all the options. Once you have all those options up, you can then go, okay, what do they specialize in? What types of things do they, and you can go through there and do that. And there's a Focus on the Family also has a Christian counselor network also that you can do the same thing with. But here's one, just the thing I'll say too, is, you know, I hear, Melissa, what you said a lot of, I don't want to start over with a new therapist, right? Because that does feel exhausting. And encouragement to that is the more you tell your story, the better and quicker you get out of it. We're able to be like, hey, it's almost like, you know, we did a body image timeline in my book. you know, timeline for anything, your life's timeline, trauma timeline, sexual timeline. Like, you could do that for anything. And so, you know, the more you've told your story and you've already unpacked a lot, you could go into a therapist and go, hey, I've already unpacked all this. Like, here's this. I've had people come in with like a little timeline thing for me. And I'm like, thank you. This is great. You know? And so then they're not having to rehash a lot of that with me. And also,
that right there, hold on, time.
Yeah.
That is so good and a huge nugget for like doing this timeline work that it doesn't just have to be for body image. It can be for other areas as well. And again, you know, when you're doing like that is hard work, like to be able to then take that. And can we just talk for a minute about this, like being proactive and advocating for yourself?
Yes.
And I think, I don't know, like, is that something that when people go in to see a therapist, do you find that often like they're ready with this stuff or do you or not? Because I would love to flip that so that people are like, here you go. This is where I'm at. And that kind of thing.
Yeah. Very few people are ready with that information. And so, no, it's something that I am trying to advocate more for because I think it will help people. Because sometimes you can change therapists for other reasons. Sometimes it was not working. Sometimes you move, the therapist moved, the hours change, right? All kinds of stuff kind of will force people to need to make a change. And so if the thing that's going to hold us back is feeling like you're starting all over, well, let's help that. And then you just said something really powerful there with the word advocate for yourself, because this is another thing that's really important that you're able to go in, like we'll just use your current example, the very not helpful thing that that therapist said to you. You now could go to your new therapist and say, hey, this is what I want help with. And I just want to let you know that when my old therapist said this to me, it was really triggering and not helpful. What's a different way that you'll be able to approach this to help me? The more you're able to speak up and tell people those kinds of things, I love when new clients even tell me, hey, I had a therapist one time that they were always giving me worksheets. I hate worksheets. Don't ever give me a worksheet. That's so helpful, right? Like, that's not rude at all. That's like, good to know. I'm so glad, you know? Yeah. I'm like, we just skipped forward several sessions because you were honest. You were real with me, right? I was you. And like, I know this is what I like and what I don't like. And then, you know, one other thing is that you can even get to where even with, like, let's say you have a working relationship with a therapist and you love them, and then they do something that you're like, that doesn't sit well with me. You can tell them that too. Like, hey, just to let you know, I've really enjoyed working with you, but man, that last session when you brought that, you did this turn, that did not sit well with me. And see, you know, most therapists, they'll work with you on it and be able to go, okay, let's talk about it. Because that just tells me it triggered something, right? And so, oh, like, whoa, okay, this thing is coming up. Let's deal with that. So,
as a coach, like, this is something that, like, I was working with a coaching client, and one of the things we were working on is helping her learn to speak up. And so, I remember the moment that she was like, that made me really uncomfortable. And I was like, you have come so far that you could, you know, have the courage to say that to me right now. Like, that is such a win, you know? And so, yes, I love that. Just the courage of learning to speak up. And I always say it doesn't take confidence. It takes courage, because with courage, you can do anything. And courage is just an opportunity to partner with God and build your faith as well. To wrap up real quick, you talk about trusting your gut and listening to your body. So tell me a little bit about that as we close. And then, of course, we'll tell everyone where to get your book and all that.
Yeah. You know, anybody who has any form of even just disordered eating or even somebody who's been a chronic lifelong dieter, anything like that, has gotten really good at shutting down being in connection with your body. it's the only way you're even able to do some of those disorder behaviors, because your body's like, hey, actually, we're really hungry right now. And you're like, shut up, body. We're not listening. Or, ooh, this really over-exercising, it hurts, you know, and I've got all these symptoms that are coming from it. And you're like, shut up, body, push through. And so we have, most people, and thus we retrain ourselves, we're used to just shutting down our bodies. Natural signals for all the things. And so we have to turn that back on. And so even the trusting of your gut, that's not necessarily a physical thing, but it can be more emotional, right? Where something doesn't sit right with you. Maybe somebody said something and you're like, whoa, that doesn't sit right. And your gut, you might feel it, you know. So for some people, they'll actually feel it in their gut, or some people, your shoulders will get tight, or you might like notice you're clenching your fist or your jaw, like you just had a physical response to it. And again, because we're not used to listening, we're like, oh, I'm probably just reading into that. That's just me being silly, or, you know, if we write it off. And so then when we want to actually build trust our gut, maybe it's on a decision we're trying to make, we're having a real hard time. Like going, what is, and obviously as a believer, I believe the Holy Spirit is our gut, right? Going, no, yeah, he's waving a red flag and we're trying to ignore the red flags and things. And so the more we do this though, it's really, I call it working your trust your gut muscles, means doing it with little things, right? In your body and even in decisions that we're making, starting really small and noticing, oh, even something as simple as, oh, I'm hungry right now. Okay, let's, you know, grab some water. Let's grab some food. And the more we actually listen, so that's a physical one, decision-wise, you know, it could be something as small as, oh, where are we going this afternoon? The more we actually listen, tune in, and then do the thing, it starts to build our trust in, oh, yeah, I can hear the messages my body is sending. I'll pay attention. And the same thing even with just decisions and things we're making.
I love that you say that, because one of the things that, as I've gone through this process, is, you know, that when you've been flying by the seat of your pants for so long, God's like, you've got to slow down and you have to pay attention and you have to listen to your body. And in that process, like, it was very pivotal. And it didn't come naturally. It came with facial swelling. That's what finally got me to do it. And I think this is similar. Like, we push and push and push and treat our body like a machine for so long until something happens that's like literally like it's so loud that we don't have a choice but to finally listen. Would you agree?
Oh, yeah, for sure. That's usually what forces somebody to stop and be like, okay, I'm listening, you know, but we don't want to get there, right? Like, we don't want to, that to have to be the thing. And so absolutely, it's, yeah, it can be the thing that motivates us at first. And then we get to where it becomes a joy to actually walk out in the direction that of God's best for us and to live in peace within our body, not war.
Yes. So to wrap up, the body image timeline, huge, like it's so powerful. I do believe it's something that everyone should do. And then, of course, you can take that with any, I would say, with any experience, anything, any category of your life. I would say definitely anywhere where it feels like there's trauma. Would you agree? Like, that's the doing a timeline for those kind of things would be helpful.
Yeah. And really, I like to explain it to people, since some people aren't always sure what is trauma, what isn't. Anywhere you feel stuck consistently in your life. If you just have one area, you're like, man, I feel like I'm beating my head against the wall. Like, I try all the things, and nothing's working. When I see somebody be stuck consistently, I'm like, all right, let's do some timeline work on this to see where this originated and where, you know, get to the root of some of this. Yeah.
I love that you say that, because this season is all about getting unstuck. That's kind of the theme for the season of the podcast. So it's a great way to wrap it up and be like, yeah, like, look for the areas where you feel stuck, if you feel stuck, and do a timeline based on that to help you kind of diagnose and figure out like what's going on in that area.
Yeah.
All right. So tell everyone where they can get your book. I'm telling you, this book is so powerful. Do you think that you'll ever write one for like teenagers?
I have people ask me that. So it's definitely on my, it's on my radar for sure. Yeah, I want to. Yeah, so they can get the book. Amazon is always the quickest, you know, usually cheapest even way to get it. If you want to just learn more about the book, you can go to imagerestoredbook.com. And, you know, since you brought up my videos, there's a QR code in the book that you can scan to access the videos. I just want to share with listeners and even you, Melissa, that one of the videos is on doing the timeline. I'm actually walking you through it. And I teach in that one something I call butterfly hugs. It just calms your nervous system. And so people have found that so helpful. And the video is like 10 minutes. So I would definitely suggest that if you're listening and you're like, I want to do a timeline and you do get the book, just scan that code and watch the video with it. People have found that to be really helpful when they're doing it. Yeah.
I also felt like your website had a lot of good, like you have, I have one bookmark, talk therapy, I believe.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
Something about that. So it's, I would definitely say people
yes.
can go to your website and find out a lot of free resources that you have available as well. But the book is so helpful. I'll put everything in the show notes so they can reach out to you, get their copy of the book and all that good stuff.
Thank you, Melissa.
Hey, friend, that's it for this episode. If you found value, I would love it if you could take a couple of seconds and leave me a quick review. While it may seem super simple, it is so beneficial and gives me the opportunity to help more women. Also, take a screenshot and share it on social media with your biggest aha today. Don't forget to tag me at Melissa Bad Official so we can connect. Thank you so much for listening. And until next time, friend, keep walking it out one baby step at a time because God's got you.